In the previous section, we talked about performance and financial indicators, and they are mostly of ratios. In this section, we'll talk about fund flow analysis, because sanctioning authorities will be interested in knowing what is the movement or what is the flow of funds. When I say flow, they are interested in knowing how much long-term funds have been mobilized, okay? How much long-term funds have been mobilized into the business, and how much has been used for long-term purposes, whether there are any surplus or deficit. Okay, so they are interested in knowing this, because surplus is good, but deficit is very detrimental to that business. Okay, so is there any deficit? If there is any deficit, how they are going to manage that deficit? What steps are being taken? Okay, and when there is a deficit, where funds were diverted? Because deficit basically means diversion of short-term funds for long-term purposes. So where it has been diverted, all those they are interested in knowing, and that's why fund flow statement plays very important role. Okay, so let's look at this. This is a typical fund flows analysis carried out by the bankers, and here if you see, you will have actual fund flow movement for previous year 2, then for previous year 1 you will have estimates in comparison with actuals, then you will also have estimate for the current year and projections. Okay, first let's focus on previous year 2 alone. This is a real fund flow, so I'll try to explain, and in the following sessions we'll take up some 3 or 4 other fund flow statement and we'll analyze scenario by scenario. Okay, so this fund flow statement, as I already said, fund flow statement will list out all long-term sources. It will list out long-term uses. Then you will know whether there is any surplus or deficit of long-term funds. Okay, so now let's look at this case. What are the possible long-term sources? Number one, cash accruals. Number two, equity funds. Number three, it can be loans in the nature of term loan, unsecured loans, and any other long-term sources. Say for example, sale of fixed assets, that is also a long-term source. Sale of long-term investment, that is also a long-term source. Okay, so in this case, if you notice, in the previous year 2, they didn't have positive cash flows, they didn't have positive cash profit, they were actually suffering cash loss. What you see here is a cash loss. In previous year 2, they lost 8.73 crore, assuming figures are in crores, they lost 8.73 crore in their business operations. Okay, so this is not an inflow, it is shown within brackets, meaning it is an outflow. They have not generated, they have not mobilized any funds from shareholders, they have not raised any term loans, but they have raised unsecured loans. So as a banker, you should be knowing from where they got, I mean from whom they have borrowed unsecured loan. What are the terms of unsecured loan? Okay, of course it is classified under long-term source, but what is the tenor? And at this juncture, any funds, the two long-term funds coming into the business is good, because they have suffered huge cash loss. So any infusion of long-term funds is good, but as a banker, you should know on what terms these unsecured loans have come. If these unsecured loans have come from promoters, it is well and good, because they have infused the funds here to take care of the business, because business is suffering huge loss. Okay, so that should be seen. Then they've also mobilized some long-term funds, and what is the exact source, it is not available. See, this fund flow statement will be automatically generated from CMA. Okay, that credit monitoring arrangement, when you input all the datas, your P&L balance sheet data, automatically it prepares this fund flow statement. So you should go back and see from where they got this 1.78 crore. Okay, is it because of say sale of asset? If it is on account of sale of asset, is it core asset? Whether they were disposing of core asset, if they are disposing of core asset, whether going concern assumption, whether it can be continued, whether this organization, this entity can sustain in future also. So all those got to be checked. Okay. So now if you see, in previous year too, they had a loss of 8.73 cash loss. They arranged unsecured loan from, let's say, promoters or from outsiders, and they also managed. It can also be a disposal of long-term investment. Okay, let's say they had some long-term investment. They felt, okay, this is the right time to dispose it off so that it can help the business. But despite doing all this, what's happening? They have a loss of 1.96. Not a loss. Actually, it's a deficit, I would say. It's a deficit because here they lost 8.73 and here they have brought in, say, close to, say, 5 or 6.77 crore. It's not helping because there is a cash loss of 8.73. So all put together, they have not generated, they have lost 1.96 crore already. Okay, it means this is not an inflow, this is an outflow. This is an outflow, point one. And now let us also look at the uses, where they have used. Long-term uses, see, the long-term uses can be towards capex, capital expenditure. It can also be towards repayment of loans, okay, many things like that. So here, if you notice, in previous year too, despite incurring such huge loss, they were investing on capital assets. Look at this, 4.19 crore they have invested in capital assets. But if you look at the long term source, they don't have long term source at all, because their long term source, if you look at it, is negative. So it is actually long term use. So they have not mobilized any money, but they are spending 4.19 crore on capital assets and on others. This others can be loan repayment, okay, or it can also be making some investments, not in the capex items, but long-term investments or investment in associate concerns, which are classified as long-term asset. So they don't have any money, but here they are investing 4.19 crore in capital items, 2.98 crore in loan repayments or say investments in associates or something, whatever. So the total outflow is 7.17 crore. So already we concluded that this is also an outflow and this is also an outflow. So 1.96 plus 7.17, your total outflow is 9.13 crore without any source. Without source, they are spending. So without source means how is that possible? The answer is, without long-term source, they are investing in long-term uses. Now this is a serious, serious situation, because from where they got this money? They have deficit of 9.13 crore. The question is, from where they got this money? Simple, it is negative working capital. It means they had current asset, but they had current liabilities, okay? And these current liabilities are greater than current asset by 9.13 crore, okay? So they have current liabilities greater than current asset, 9.13 crore, and that current liability was used for funding this deficit. So what's the big deal here? The big issue is this 9.13 crore had come from current liability. Current liabilities are repayable within a period of 1 year, okay? Whereas this 9.13 crore got invested under long-term uses, which will take more than 1 year for disposing or for converting into cash. So here you have the checkpoint. Current liabilities are repayable within 1 year, but these assets can be converted into cash only after a period of 1 year. So there is a checkpoint, and if these current liabilities, if they demand for the payment, the operations of this company will come to a standstill. Why? This organization cannot afford to pay this current liability. This current liability can be a bank CC, it can be a bank CC or OD, or it can be sundry creditors, whatever. But if they demand for payment, this entity will not be in a position to pay. And what these guys will do? They will eventually go to court of law, and they will also ask for winding up petition of this company. Why? Because they are not making the payment. So that serious is the situation here, and that can be understood very easily by looking at this fund flow statement.